We economists try to understand how individuals make choices. In doing that, we have several tools and basic principles to see the world. One of the most important ones is the observation that individuals react to incentives. And when reacting to incentives, they adjust their behavior accordingly. And that's true when an individual is trying to make a choice, especially when they face constraints such as limited resources, limited time, different wants and needs, and all the kind of things. A classic example of the incentives matter principle is the price system. If the price of something goes up, you will buy less of it, or you will tend to buy less of it. If the price of something goes down, you will tend to buy more of it. If you don't like something, it doesn't matter how much it costs, you simply don't care about it. But if you are already buying some things, if that product is part of your normal consumption and the price of that is changes, you will adjust your behavior accordingly. Let's say that you like coffee and the price of coffee goes up and you also like tea. Probably you will tend to replace coffee with tea because it's cheaper and you will get the same satisfaction of that consumption. In a market economy, prices are signals that convey some valuable information for both consumers and producers. Think about a producer of furniture. If the price of wood goes up, that tells the producer something about their business. Probably he or she will try to replace that raw material for a cheaper one, or the price will increase, or they will try to make their production process more efficient in order to adjust to that signal that the price is sending to them. So they react to the incentive that the price system is setting. Monetary incentives are not the only ones that matter. We economists tend to focus more on monetary incentives because they are easier to observe. But there are a whole bunch of non-monetary incentives that are really important. People care about their reputation. People care about love. People care about their time. And of course, those incentives also affect their behavior. Those things also affect the incentive structure that surrounds the environment within the individual make choices. For example, I mean, if you want your wife to wash the dishes, probably it's not a very good idea to offer her $10, right? Probably your spouse will respond better to other type of incentives, like caring about her or him taking care of the house or the kids or what have you, right? It is hard to measure how incentives will impact behavior. We can have a sense of in which way the individual will move in their choices when facing incentives. But that's an important observation. Like, what is important for me might not be important for someone else in my incentive structure. There is people that care more about reputation than others. Criminal, I doubt that they care about their reputation with society. Probably they care about their reputation with their fellow criminals, being tough or being ruthless. Right? But what I'm trying to say is that different individuals will react in a different way facing the same incentive, right? So incentives are very context specific. Think about if the price of oranges goes up, right? Probably somebody likes oranges so much that it will not matter. They will still buy the same amount of oranges. But for someone that don't care a lot about oranges, they will probably try to substitute by buying apples. So the same incentive, price of oranges goes up, can have different effects on choices for different individuals, right? Sometimes we make the mistake to think that incentives will work the same for everybody, and that's not the case.